Hello and welcome back to Living Not Existing. As always, I'm Josh, and well, it's been a plenty long enough time since the last video, and finally getting back to it. Life's just been busy, but that's another story for another day and all that sort of thing. But yeah, so we're going to get in it on the plot. But before I do, one thing I'm going to show is a new adventure machine, and that is part of the new plans of things that are coming up in the future videos. So if you want any more things on anything like that and to know about that, drop a comment down below. But as for now, let's get into it. So, we are on the plot, and as you can probably see around behind me, it's a total mess. It's gone right downhill because of busyness, as I say. But there is a reason for all of this stuff. So as you can see over my shoulder to the left of me, that is a massive pile of wood. Now that pile of wood I've scored via work, which is amazing because that there is going to be a load of burning material and a load of construction material, which is perfect because there's loads of construction work to be going on. Hence today's video. So, what I've also got is I've got a bag of compost. Growing season's about to start, so I've got to get started with summit. And then I've also got on here, you can see big long pieces of wood, telegraph poles. Now you might be thinking, why on earth have I got telegraph poles? If you've got a guess, drop it in the comments below. But the reasoning is, behind me, where the shed is there, the pump house shed as I'm calling it, I'm going to build onto the front of there a big massive greenhouse, because as I'm sure everyone has seen over the years on here, I've always got loads of glass, but there's a reason. I've been planning on building a huge greenhouse, so I've acquired a load more, as well as bags of rubbish, but a load more glass, some lovely, lovely window frames, and what I'm going to do is build that structure and set these posts in the ground and then basically frame it up and fill it full of glass. So might as well get cracking on, get doing something, because this place heavily needs organising. So let's get into it. So I've now got one of the big posts moved over here, and as you can see to my left, someone new. So this is Emma. So
hello.
Everyone say hello to Emma, drop it down there. But yeah, so we're in the region of where the greenhouse is going now. And as I say, the post is over, and as you can see, Emma is really handily stood there with a spade. She's been extremely hard at work getting the two big holes we need to sink the two main posts in. She's got them all dug out, which is excellent. So as you'll be seeing on the screen now, obviously there's all these big holes. So those big holes are what we're going to be putting the thing in. So what we're now going to do is we're now going to basically continue to drag these posts over and get them upright. So we shall be doing that now.
Traveling in a Friday combi on a hippie trailhead full of zombies. I met a strange lady, she made me nervous.
So, as you've just seen, we've got one up in the air now, vertical, and that's been fairly sturdy already, just with some mud around it, which is surprising. I thought I was going to have to tie the whole structure together to get any rigidity in them, because obviously you're not using concrete, you're just keeping it as natural as possible. And yeah, so I've done that, and then this big one right here, that is heavy as all, yeah, ridiculous. So I've had to do the good old classic, phone a friend. So my friend is on the way down now, and then we'll be lifting it. So we'll be waiting for him to arrive, sorting a few bits, and then we'll try and get this big one in the air, because they even got the pulleys out and everything to try and do it. So I'm going to see if I can make that a bit better and get a few more like 3-to-1s going on or something like that. And yeah, because that's heavy. So, got an additional pair of hands now, my friend Jordan. He's down, he's done loads on this plot over the time, since the last videos and stuff like that as well, helping out with things and everything. But more stories for another day, as I keep saying. So, what I've now got, we've got another pair of hands. So me and Jordan are going to get on this big log down here and get that vertical. Meanwhile, as well as that, Emma is going to be pulling the rope that she's got hold of, which has got, what is it, 3 points, 4 points, can't remember. So we're going off of that, so we're pulling at the base of my IBCs that I've now got, and they're full, so that weighs a ton, like literally a ton, so that is not going to go anywhere. He says this could be comedic. To the pulley there, to the main gate fence post for the base, back to the IBCs. So we've got multiple points reducing the amount of weight through a load of rigging knowledge and things. Yeah, so fingers crossed this is all going to go well. Let's see what happens, eh?
Fail on me.
So that's that. So now what the next thing is, we need to get some timber up the timber pile and then join all this together into the existing pump house structure to make it a sturdy thing. Because they're solid there, but a big gust of wind and they're probably going to end up inside the chicken shed, which wouldn't be very good at all. So we'll crack on doing that and then, yeah, show you the progress. So, as we've just been working out with the timber and stuff that I've got in the big pile over there and everything, turns out probably should have got one of these things out earlier, tape measure. It turns out even the long pieces of timber you can see leaning up there just behind Jordan, there's even they're not long enough to go from the shed wall to the pylon post. So even they're not big enough. So what we've decided to do now is, as you can see, it's mocked up here. We've got one of the big panes of glass that's going in and a vertical post just to go in, and it's going to tie it together with the actual frames of the glass and stuff like that basically, and just use a lot of screws is probably what's going to be going on. So we're just going to crack on and see if we can build a greenhouse.
Cleaning windows to earn an honest bob. For a nosy parker, it's an interesting job. Now it's a job that just suits me. A window cleaner you would be if you could.
So, we've now managed to get the structure built as much as this. And so we've got a good start of a wall of glass going in. One of the big panes this part. Obviously it's all higgledy-piggledy, it's, you know, chunky old allotment shed, or greenhouse, should I say. But yeah, so we've got that in, a bit of working out there with that. Unfortunately a little bit of smashed glass on my part, that was just, is how it is, if you're right. It's double glazing, so only one pane of the double is actually cracked, so it's not too bad. It'll stay there, and we'll just see how it goes. If I need to swap it out at a later date, I'll swap it out. Simple. But yeah, so we've got this up, it's now pretty sturdy. There's a little bit of a wobble, but it's okay. And then what we've done around here is, because my camera died partway through the time lapse, I had not seen the back end of it, but what we've now got is we've now got this all tied together up here as well. So I've left all of, obviously that bit will come off, but I've left all of these bits on because I feel it's going to help with putting some roof joists in for then putting a glass roof on. That's the idea, is to have a glass roof. We'll see how it goes though. And then also, as you can see on some of these here, I've got tie backs back to the main fence. So these tie backs go into the main fence. That is because what I want to try and do is these IBCs, so obviously that's full of water, and the thermal properties of water is actually not that great really. So what the plan is but not that great, but great, depends on how you look at it. But what I can do is, if I enclose these into the actual greenhouse, the idea is during the day it's going to heat up the water, which is going to help with it not getting too hot during the day in the summer months, because it's having to heat up all this water as well. But then on a night when it goes cold, it'll keep the temperature internally a lot hotter. So when it comes to the start of the season, like now for example, for next year, when it comes to it, I don't know, it might help out this year already, but for next year especially, it will start the growing season off earlier inside of here, as opposed to having any sort of like paraffin heater or something like that within. I'll just use natural heat and have a heat source like this. And if I find any big boulders, I might put a couple of them in places as well, because it's the same principle. Heat them up, and that's where you're going to get the lasting heat from. But yeah, so that is the structure for now. Obviously, there is all sorts of things in here, other timber bits. But the daylight is about to fade, and it fades pretty rapidly. So I'm going to call that a day for today. That is the start of the grand greenhouse, higgledy-piggledy greenhouse, getting built. And yeah, so we'll be continuing again. Hopefully not too long. Hopefully tomorrow. We shall see what happens. But yeah, so that is that. And I'm pretty happy with the progress. Oh, one thing I did do that you could see is the doors. So the doors are going to go in this side, hence why I've got this beam up here. So there'll be two double opening doors. They'll open internally. And yeah, I'm pretty happy with the progress, considering this has been an ongoing thing for about 2 years. I mean, look how solid that is. I'm leaning things against it already and it's not going anywhere. But yeah, so great, I'm really happy. Well, that's that for today. It's all sorted, daylight's disappearing. But I say all sorted, partially sorted, but really happy with the progress. And of course, a great thank you to Emma for helping out, and of course, my good mate Jordan for helping out. And yeah, it's great to be back. And as always, remember to like, comment, subscribe, check out the Facebook and Instagram links below, and the new one, which is the TikTok link down below, because yeah, I'm going to give that a go for a change. And yeah, so that's that. So until the next video, thank you all very much for watching. I'm Josh, been living not existing. Goodbye. Bye.